Let's start working on a very fundamental equation in differential equations. That's the homogeneous second order ODE with constant coefficients. We can write the general equation as A x double dot plus B x dot plus C x equals 0. Homogeneous means 0 on the right hand side. Constant coefficients means A, B, and C are constant. So how are we going to solve this equation? We're going to make use of the principle of superposition. So we're going to look for two solutions of this equation, two solutions that have a non-zero Wronskian, so we can satisfy two initial conditions. We're going to search for two solutions using what I call the ansatz method. That means we're going to, by an ansatz, that means we're going to guess the form ansatz here. We're going to guess the form of the solution that has a free parameter. And by substituting into the differential equation, we're going to determine the free parameter. So what is the natural guess for an equation of this type? We would like to convert the differential equation into an algebraic equation. To do that, we want to have some functional form for x that functional form will cancel after we substitute in. We rack our memory for the type of function that when you differentiate it, you get back the same function. And we think of the exponential function. So the proper ansatz here will be an exponential function. We can see how it works. But where does the free parameter go? You can see that we try to find a solution of this equation. If we put the free parameter as a multiplying constant, that multiplying constant will just cancel. It won't do us any good. So the free parameter here actually should go in the exponential function. So we try x of t equals e to the rt. R then is an unknown parameter. And we hope that by substituting this ansatz into the differential equation, we'll end up with an algebraic equation for R. So we substitute in. The second derivative brings down an r squared. So we'll have an a r squared e to the rt plus b, the first derivative brings down an r, times e to the rt plus c times e to the rt equals 0. Our choice of exponential function is rewarded here, because this function then cancels out of the equation. And we end up with a quadratic equation for r. A r squared plus b r plus c equals 0. This equation has a name. It's called the characteristic equation. Okay. If you know your matrix algebra, the equation for the eigenvalue is also called a characteristic equation. And in fact, there's a relationship between this and the eigenvalue problem. But here, we just know that this quadratic equation we get from the substitution x equals e to the rt is called the characteristic equation. What are the solutions of this equation? There are actually three cases that we have to deal with, right? Well, first of all, let's write down the solution. So the solution of a quadratic equation of that form is just given by the quadratic formula. So we have two solutions, r plus or minus equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, just the quadratic formula. But in this type of solution for two r's, Remember, two r's means we have two functions, e to the r plus t and e to the r minus t. But three things can happen here that we have to pay attention to. So what are those three things? The first one is b squared minus 4ac might be positive. Then we have distinct real roots, right? Distinct real roots. So we have two roots, r1 and r2, or r plus and r minus. The second thing that can happen is that b squared minus 4ac may be negative. Then we have the square root of a negative number. That means we have complex conjugate roots. So we have negative b plus something times I, well, negative b over 2a plus something times I, and negative b over 2a minus something times I. So this is complex conjugate roots. So in this case, we're going to have to understand how do we interpret e to the rt when r is complex. And then the last case that we'll have to deal with is b squared minus 4ac equals 0. Then we have repeated roots, or sometimes called degenerate roots. In this case, there's only one root of the characteristic equation. We find only one r. We have only one solution, x equals e to the rt. In order to satisfy two initial conditions, we need a second solution. We don't know what the second solution is. What that means is that our ansatz has failed in the second solution case. The second solution is not in the form e to the rt. It's in a different form. So in this third case, then, the main task for us will be to find that second solution. So let me review. We're starting our study of homogeneous second-order ODEs with constant coefficients. The general differential equation is just ax double dot plus bx dot plus cx equals 0. Our solution method basically guesses the solution with a free parameter, r. We guess an exponential function, e to the rt, because the exponential function will cancel out of the equation, leaving us an algebraic equation for r. This is called the characteristic equation of the differential equation. Because it's a quadratic equation, one of three things can happen. We can have distinct real roots, in which case we have two exponential functions, e to the r plus t and e to the r minus t. We then apply the principle of superposition to that. We can have complex conjugate roots, in which case we have two complex exponential functions. We will learn how to deal with that to get two real functions. Or we can have repeated roots, in which case we only have one exponential function, and we're going to have to do some magic to get the second solution. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.